Now, if you've watched the pen and paper lecture on talking about an introduction at least to complex matrices, let's see how easy it is to deal with this using Python. So we've opened the notebook that we've been working on, complex valued vectors and matrices. Now do remember, watch the whole series, because what is the aim of me showing you how to use Python for your mathematics? First of all, to aid your understanding of the mathematics. Well, two, just to show you, but you can check your work, you can do things so much easier, especially those repetitive, simple calculations like a row times a column as far as a dot product is concerned. You know, there's a lot of work involved there, specifically when the matrices and vectors get big, and it's just so much easier to do it in Python. And then lastly, well, you can just pick up a bit of Python just by looking at the mathematics. So do remember, there's a link in the description down below to a video that where I show you just how to set up your Google Drive so that you can use Google Colab, a notebook such as this, and just type your Python code without having to install anything on your system. As a quick reminder, remember right at the start, we did our import. So we said from sympy, the symbolic Python package, we're going to import the init underscore printing function, and then we call that function so that when we use sympy code, the result of that code is going to look like our textbook. And then from sympy, I imported some specific keywords, the I keyword, uppercase I, that's the imaginary unit, the symbols function to create mathematical symbols such that we can use them as variables, the matrix function, uppercase M, that's going to create matrix objects for us, the square root function, the uppercase ABS function, that's going to calculate, for instance, the absolute value of a real number, but also the modulus of a complex number, the adjoint function, the double O's, well, that stands for infinity, the EQ function, that's for equations, and the solve function. And then before, we also just looked at the dagger function from the physics.quantum.dagger module inside of sympy. I just showed you can use that as well. But that's more to do with working with sympy and with Python as far as quantum mechanics is concerned. So let's talk about complex valued matrices. We see a matrix here. It's a two row, three column complex valued matrix. It's given at least the name A or the symbol A, and we've got to recreate that. Because that's what it was given, we might as well create a computer variable with the same name, just uppercase A. Then the equal symbol, remember that's the assignment operator, and then I'm calling the matrix function. I'm just going to pass all the values as a Python list object to this matrix function, and I've got to just remember that I'm going to go row by row. So 1, and then 2 plus I, and then 3, and then 2 plus I again, and then negative I, and then 7. And once that object's created, I'm calling the reshape method on that object, which is like applying a function to this object and then saying two rows, comma, three columns, and then we're just printing A to the screen. So just a bit of revision there. There you can see, because we used the init underscore printing function right at the top, we now get this beautiful LaTeX version of the output, and it looks like our mathematical textbook. Not only that, it actually looks like this LaTeX code that we used up here to create this matrix. Let me just double click here to show you. And there we see some LaTeX code. We see this backslash begin B matrix 1. We see the ampersand symbol, the 2 plus I, and then ampersand again 3, and then 2 backslashes. And then that's just some LaTeX code. If I just execute that cell, we see that is what happens. We see this mathematical typesetting. But our code is doing the exact same thing. It's creating this matrix object, but it prints it out nicely to the screen. There's a matrix B, it's also a two row, three column, and I'm going to create it just in a slightly different way. We can see I'm still passing a Python list object. I know it's a list object because it's enclosed in square brackets, but instead of, you know, just doing all of those six elements in a row separated by commas, I'm using a nested list object. So if you look closely, there is a set of square brackets inside of the outer set of square brackets, and that is just row by row. So we see 1 plus I, comma I, comma 4 minus I, and then in the second row I have another Python list object, but they're all inside of a larger set of square brackets, and that would be another way to create this instead of using the reshape method. And if we print that to the screen, we see, oh, we've created a beautiful matrix object there. So let's talk a little bit about complex matrix arithmetic. The first thing we always talk about is scalar matrix multiplication. And so let's just print B to the screen again by just calling B. Remember, we assigned that matrix B to the computer variable B, so we can just call B and it gets printed to the screen. But what we want to calculate is minus 1, the scalar minus 1 times B. And I'm just doing that minus 1 times B. And you can see we're just going to distribute that negative 1 through each of the elements. So 1 plus I becomes negative 1 minus I. I becomes minus or negative I, etc. So if we want to add A and B, which we can because they're both two row, three column matrices, and it's just element wise addition. If we want to do subtraction, let's just print A to the screen again, just so that we have it there. And let's print out negative 1 times B. And there you can see, so if we do element wise, it's going to be 1, that little 1 there, added to this minus 1 minus I right there. So what I've done is A plus negative 1 times B, just to show you that matrix subtraction is nothing other than the combination of scalar matrix multiplication and matrix addition. So let's just run that, and we see the result there. Indeed, if I take I and I add to that negative 1 negative I, I'm just going to get the negative I, because 1 added to that negative 1, that's a 0. And let's just do straight off the bat, let's just do A minus B. And you're going to see there the result is exactly the same. So subtraction is not really something on its own. It's just this combination of scalar matrix multiplication and then matrix addition. So let's look at complex matrix vector multiplication. Just remind ourselves to print A to the screen before we created this vector U. And then we just print it to the screen. We see it is three column matrix. And that means we can multiply A by U because we've got three columns in A and we've got three rows, at least I should say, in U. So just multiplying A times U, very easy. We just say A times U, and we see it is just dot products. First row and the column, second row and the column. And our result is a 2x1 matrix. Although we see the algebra hasn't taken place yet, we don't see expansion there of this multiplication. So what we can do is we create a single object, A times U, put that inside of parentheses, so we generate a single object, and then we call the expand method on that. So we just get expansion of that multiplication, and then we see our final result, 19 plus 2i and 28 minus 5i. If we think about this complex matrix multiplication, I'm going to create this matrix C such that I can multiply A by C. So let's do that. There's my matrix C. Again, this time I've created it by nested list object, so square brackets inside of square brackets, and it goes row by row. So you see the 1, 1, and then the 2, i, and then the 4 plus 2i, and 1. There's C. I'm going to just multiply A by C. I can do that because A is a 2x3 matrix, C is a 3x2 matrix, and the result's going to be a 2x2 matrix. Once again, we see that the expansion didn't take place, and so we can just create a single object, A times C, put it in parentheses to make sure that it's a single object, so that when I apply the expand method, we see expansion. And there we can see our final 2x2 matrix. It's a lot of fun, it's so easy, and it looks so nice if you use symbolic Python. Give it a go.